rappers like T.I. have something to say, you know. They, you know, actually spread a message, you know. And with T.I., what I like about T.I., he's not glorifying violence. He's expressing how his neighborhood is, where he's from, or violence is, you know, occurred. Unlike Soulja Boy, you know, he does songs, you know, to make you dance and, you know, just to be party club songs, happy and things like that. There's no real message into having fun. Everybody can.
Well, I know it doesn't affect my life, but for other people, they listen to it and they think that they 50 Cent, they think that they get money and stuff like that, and it's not really true.
I listen to rap music, I listen to country western, I listen to jazz, I listen to rock and roll, and I listen to R&B. R&B and jazz are my favorites. When it first started, when the original rap artists began, there was no violence in it, and it was all about the rhyme, and it's all about the rhyme scheme, and it was all about having fun, and that's what rap music was originally intended to be. Then it sort of got this East Coast, West Coast, gang-related sort of violent thing, and that's when it became something that I didn't like listening to. The way that rap music has affected my life is, it's affected my life as a principal, because so many of the children that I deal with listen to rap music, and they get the wrong message sent to them. And the message that they're sent is that young African-American men and women are supposed to be violent, that they're supposed to say things that you wouldn't necessarily hear them say if they weren't listening to rap music, and it makes them try different things and different actions that they wouldn't have normally tried if they hadn't been listening to that.
With beef in the industry, sometimes it's not even as serious as people make it seem. You know, sometimes beef is just there to boost up record sales, you know, to help one artist, you know, make some money. And just like you said, Papoose, you know, he made a beef record and it didn't get played as much as 50 Cent's record, and his record got played like crazy over Fat Joe's, you know, whole album. So, you know, it's all about record sales, you know what I'm saying? Some beef is real, others is just for publicity.
No, it's not homophobic. I mean, what do you expect? Why? It's homophobic. No.
Okay, this is gay rapper. His name's Aerosol. Most people know him as Ken Kenneth. His albums get no play. His mixtapes get no play. Why would that be?
Rap music, it portrays violence, but it's not gonna make you go out just because the song tells you that. Just because the song says they're gonna go out, kill somebody, don't mean you should go out and kill somebody. It doesn't tell you to do that. It just portrays it in a light in which people think it's cool.
Who's your favorite rap artist?
My favorite rap artist is Eminem. M is not violent on a level of what you're thinking about. M is violent, like, based on stuff that's happened in his life. I mean, he's not just gonna put a violent track out to put a violent track out.
A lot of hip-hop artists, you know, are involved in things that are outside of the music industry, you know, that they can't help dodging sometimes, you know. Can't help what happens in the streets that they probably been doing or try to change, you know. Sometimes it just catches up to them in ways where maybe they didn't want to glorify the violence, and some others, well, they still represent violence and, you know, continue to keep it going. So it all depends on the artist and what they're trying to express to the people or the audience.